Hello everyone, a very good morning to all of you students. This is Assistant Professor Ishani Trivedi from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Now students, previously we had been discussing about the specific type of equipment, that is excavating equipment, right? We have been already done with the power shovels and then we had discussed about the drag lines as well, right? Now today we are going to discuss about further another type of excavator, that is the first is going to be the hoe excavator and the second is going to be the clamshells, right? Now let us have a look. Right in front of you we have the equipment called the hoe excavator. Now there are also other names regarding the hose or the hoe excavator. You can call it as a front loader, you can call it as back loader, then we also have another name as back shovel, you can also call it as pull shovel, right? So basically what happens over here is we have the power shovel, right? You can see right in front of you, and I'm also going to bring a comparative study between the power shovel and the hoe excavator. Now students, you have two images right in front of you. The first image is of a hoe excavator, which you can see at the top, and the second is the power shovel. Now what is the difference that you can see in both of them? First, if I talk about similarity, then both of them are type of an excavator, right? Both of them are having the same purpose, which are used to perform excavation work on the soil, on the earth. Second, in the hoe excavator you can see that the power shovel bucket, right, we had called it dipper when we talked about the power shovel. We have discussed about its various parts. It had a boom stick, it had arm, it had hydraulic cylinder and the dipper stick and the hoisting cable, right? So now instead of dipper we can also call it as bucket over here. So we can see that it is rear mounted. In the hoe excavator we can see it is rear mounted, while in the bottom one we can see it is front mounted. But again, that doesn't cause a big difference. It can be rear mounted, it can be front mounted, both of them. If it is rear, then it is a back loader, then, and if it is in the front, then it is front loader, hoe front loader, right? One more thing which we can see is in the front, what is mounted is the dozer blade, right? We have studied about bulldozer already. So what happens here is excavation work is performed, and along with you can also collect the material, the dump material, the digged material, the dug material in the dozer bucket, and then you can simultaneously spread it evenly on the surface. Both the work can be done. Now the difference, major difference which comes over here is the shape of the bucket, right? In the power shovel you can see the bucket is going to make outward strokes, right? It is going to make outward stroke, meaning its bucket is going to dig it in such a way that your bucket, the teeth of the bucket is going to dig in the forward direction, that is away from your operating cabin. While in the hoe excavator it so happens that your bucket, the teeth of your bucket will be making inward strokes, right? It will be making inward strokes just like the drag lines. We have seen how the drag line works. So many of the mechanisms over here are just same as the drag lines, right? So it is going to perform the excavation such that the digging of the soil will be done towards our machine, towards our operating cabin, meaning there will be inward strokes. Now because of this particular reason, what happens is the power shovel can dig above its track level only, while in case of hoe excavator you can dig below the track level as well, just like the drag lines. Okay, so this is the difference, major difference over here. But there also come certain limitations. You can work in the soil where heavy boulders are not present, heavy rocks are not present. In such cases only you can use this type of excavator. This is also one of the types of the power shovel. You can call it as power shovel as well. So this is your type of the excavating equipment called hoe excavator. Now let us talk about the definition which we already discussed. We are going to just put it in technical terms. So we have back hoe, right? Here the name is back hoe. It can be front hoe, it can be back shovel, right? You can call anything you want. So back hoe is also termed as hoe. It is known as back shovel, it is pull shovel, and it is an excavating machine of the power shovel group itself, which we already discussed in the discussion regarding power shovel versus the hoe excavator. It is used to excavate below the track level. I already explained that mechanism, that is ultimately the operation of the hoe excavator, which we will study further. And it also removes the earth as it caves into the ground to establish slope. Now see students, this is going to become your application. I have said that you will be able to find out the application advantage and disadvantage already in the theory which we discussed. So this becomes your application as well. It is used to establish natural slope to carry out the excavation work for leveling and loading because dozer blade is also present. Then you can also carry out laying of foundation trenches and footings and basement, meaning something which is below the track level. For that type of excavation, you can perform with the hoe excavator. Now, how does it work? Like the power shovel, you can see right in front of you, we have a cross-sectional sketch, a diagram in which all the parts are shown in right in front of you. The same thing was done in the power shovel also. You should be able to see that there is not much of a major difference between these two. The parts like the operating cabin, the mounting at the bottom, the boom, the arm cylinder, all of these things are kind of same. But there is no dipstick over here because your bucket is not in outward stroke position. But here you are going to have your bucket such that it will be attached to the hydraulic cylinder and it will be performing the work towards your operating cabin. So you can see the image in front of you. You are also supposed to draw this. So we have a cap, that is your operating cap. Then we have a boom, we have arm, that is its operating hand, that is arm cylinder, right? Then we have the arm cylinder, meaning that will be the hydraulic cylinder. And then we have the bucket at the bottom. The tracks means the mounting. Here you can see that crawler mounted hoe excavator can be seen in front of you. In general, we already have two types. We have wheel mounted and we have crawler mounted. At the bottom, you can see the real image, that how the excavator looks. And I think it is very much familiar to you as well. So the operation is similar to that of a power shovel, which we discussed. But here the major difference comes is that the digging is done such that your bucket is dragged towards your operating cabin, meaning inward strokes are given to it, just in the case of a drag line, right? In the drag line also, you are providing a pull force, a drag pull force, and because of that, the teeth were going to dig the soil and collect the soil into the bucket. This is how your hoe excavator works. Now, the boom stick is set to an angle. Now, it was also one of the factors affecting output of the power shovel, that you have to set the necessary angle for the boom stick to perform your work. So here again, you can set it at necessary angle, and the hoist cable is pulled in and the drag cable is released and the work is done. The operating mechanism is just the same as the drag line over here. We just don't have the dragging chains, we just have the hoist cable. This is how your operation of hoe excavator is done. You can also write down the applications, advantage and disadvantage based on the theory which we studied. And I think you will be able to derive it directly on your own after watching this video properly. Next, the capacity of the bucket. It varies from 0.38 meter cube to 3.25 meter cube, which you are supposed to remember. Now, next, last excavating equipment which we are going to talk about is the clam shells. What is the name, students? It says clam shells. Now, again, just as in the case of the drag line, the name itself was explaining what kind of mechanism will be done. Here again, the name itself is going to suggest that what kind of work will be done. Clam shell, right? The shell. You know what is a shell, right? You have seen the shell which you can obtain from the beaches. Now, shell is generally a closed structure. It will be having two equal halves. It will be having two parts. You can open it in this position, right? The shell opens in this position. Now, from this concept of a regular shell, regular fish shell, it is derived, and the bucket is made so like that over here that it becomes your clam shell. Meaning the bucket will be in the shape of a shell. Right, if you can see right in front of you, I have also enlarged the picture of the bucket, and you can also see that how it is mounted with the crawler mounting unit. and also you can see that a crane is attached with the clam shell in front of you, which we are going to call it as the hoist cable and the boom stay. It can be crane, it can be cylinder, whatsoever. So how does the bucket of a clam shell work, right? It will be hinged. The two equal halves, the two equal shells of your clamshell will be hinged at top, and with the help of that hinge you will be able to open the clamshell in this manner. Then the teeth which will be present at the bottom will dig the soil. It will dig the soil and collect it in the bucket, and then you can lift up the equipment with the help of the crane. So what did we derive over here, right? Excavation work can be performed in vertical plane. Till now we were performing the excavation in the horizontal plane, but with the help of clamshell you can perform the excavation work in the vertical plane. You are going to grab the soil, you are going to grab the soil in vertical plane, and then you are going to lift it, and then you will swing it and you will dump it. Let us move forward with the proper theories regarding the same. So the name of the shape of its bucket is derived from the shell of the fish, which calls it as a clamshell, which we already discussed. It can be opened in two parts. The front end of the machine is of that of a crane, which I said that the mounting will be done with the help of the crane, and we are going to call it as a boom cable already. Next, it is hung from a lattice boom crane. I said already that the crane is going to be called as the boom stick over here. We will call it as a boom crane. Through the cables, as in the case of a drag line. Now, the bucket consists of two shells. I have highlighted right in front of you that these are the two shells, two parts of your bucket. It will be hinged at top. The long boom of the clamshell is supported by the boom cables, right? I'm highlighting the boom cables over here, right? It is just the hoisting cable and passing over the two side sheaves, right? I'm highlighting the sheaves in front of you. Can you see? Right, the part just above the two shells, which connects both of the shells, is known as sheaves. The sheaves will be connected directly to the hoisting cable, and this is how your work will be done. Let us talk about the proper type of the bucket which we are talking about, because here what is different is your bucket, right? So the selection of the bucket depends on the type of the job. It can be construction of diaphragm wall, it can be vertical lifting, it can be excavation in the confined areas. See students, what these things I am speaking are ultimately the applications of the clamshells. Ultimately the advantage you can derive, the opposite of the application can be your disadvantages. So it depends on what type of work you are performing. So according to that, it will be light weight, that will be small weight, medium weight, and heavy duty. So heavy duty type is used for digging in the hard soil. Now one advantage came over here is you can perform the excavation in the hard soil, in the rock soil. Lightweight type for handling the lighter materials, and medium weight type for the general purpose. I am showing you right in front of you the medium type of bucket. What will be the difference in all these three things? The capacity of the bucket, right? So bucket capacity is measured in terms of volume, and it will be 0.38 meter cube up to 3.06 meter cube. Based on these values, you will decide what type of work can be done. Next, we are going to talk about specific applications of the clamshell. Mark that here the applications are more important as compared to the other types, because here the things are changing. First, for vertical lifting of the material, which we already discussed, then digging and dumping in vertical plane. I said about the mechanism that how you can carry out the work in vertical plane, and simultaneously you can swing it with the crane and then you can dump it. So that is your second application. Next, we have trenches and pits in confined areas. Now if you want to carry out the excavation work for foundation trench, or you want to carry out the trial pit, and if the area is such that its adjoining property is confined, you cannot disturb the side properties, or if you are dealing with area containing water, so in such confined areas you can carry out directly, you can extend the crane, and then with the clamshell work can be performed. Next, it says dumping in confined areas. Now if you can carry out the digging work, the excavation work, then simultaneously dumping can also be done in the confined areas. Next, removing the material from the cofferdams. Now you already know what is a cofferdam, what is a caisson, and once the work is done, you will have to remove the material from inside which is gathered. So for that purpose, clamshells can be used. For well foundation, that is your open caisson, for sewer manholes, and any kind of such vertical structures where you cannot go inside directly, for that purpose clamshells can be used. Okay students, so we are keeping up to here. From the next session, we'll discuss about other type of construction equipment. So till then, memorize all the types of excavator. Have a good day students. Thank you.